In the last 24 hours, Bitcoin has risen from the lows of $31,000 to about $39,000 with an increase of 12.5%. Is this the end of the downside for Bitcoin, and are we going to see a rise to $100,000? In today's video, we are going to check out two very important Bitcoin charts, and also we are going to look at the Bitcoin dominance and see where we could be heading. So you definitely don't want to miss this video.
Subscribe to watch more videos like this.
Hello friends, my name is Soham and I welcome you to Crypto Bulls Club, your one-stop destination for all the technical analysis and news from the world of cryptocurrencies. If you're new, make sure you hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon. This will notify you with all the new videos that we release, and we release new videos every day. Also, if you'd like to discuss about Bitcoin or any other cryptocurrencies, head over to Telegram and join our family. The link is given in the description below. Also, if you'd like to read about Bitcoin or any other cryptocurrencies, head over to our website, cryptobullsclub.com, wherein we post very interesting articles. Also on the website, you can book a crypto consulting session with our experts, and you can clarify any doubts that you might have about any cryptocurrency or strategize your portfolio. This will be a paid service. Now, let's jump on to the charts. So first of all, we will be on the Bitcoin US dollar 4-hour chart. So today we are going to cover the 4-hour chart and the 1-hour chart. So on the 4-hour chart, what we can see over here, so there are plenty of lines over here, right? So the white line that we see over here is the resistance that Bitcoin has been facing right from 12th of May onwards. So that started from 12th of May, and we have been treating this line as a resistance all the way through. And it is only today that we have been able to break above this line of resistance. Now, what was the reason that we broke above the line of resistance? On the 4-hourly chart, we can see that we were actually forming a dropping wedge. As we know, a dropping wedge is a very bullish pattern for any kind of asset, right? So we formed this dropping wedge, and we had a resistance at about $36,850. So we broke it on the next candle, and then our strong resistance of this line that we have been forming since the past 12 days or so, we actually broke above it, and we also went above the $38,000 mark. But then again, the $38,000 will be a very, very strong resistance going forward as well. So we got rejected. So we have about 41 minutes still to go for this 4-hourly candle to close. By the time you are seeing this video, we would have definitely closed this candle. So what I would recommend you to is pause this video right here and go and check out whether we have been able to close this candle above this white line, or we have actually corrected down. If we are able to close above this white line, then our next resistance would definitely be $38,180. That is the 61.8 level Fibonacci on the 4-hourly time frame. So once we break that, then we could go for some long trades. By the way, for our premium members, they took a trade right at about $37,000. And they sold at around $38,500. So big congratulations to all of you who took this trade. For people who haven't still joined our premium group, make sure you join it, because we have certain very important calls wherein you can make very quick trades and make money. Now we are going to head over to the 1-hour chart. Now you might have a question why our premium members took a trade at $37,000. The reason for that, we closed the 10 AM UTC candle right on this falling wedge, and then we started this candle at about $37,000, and we took the trade at $37,000 and we closed it at $38,500. Now what was the reason for us to closing at $38,500? For that, we are going to take a look at the Fib retracement, which would actually tell us why did we do that. So our resistance for Bitcoin was at $38,860, but we closed it at about $38,850. Now that is the reason why we gave a call of $38,850 and our traders actually followed that and made some good profit. Now, what is important for Bitcoin currently as we are seeking on the 1 hour chart is we need to close above this level of 37,200, which is very important at this point of time, and there is about 37 minutes left for this candle to close by the time I'm recording this video. Now, if we tend to close above this blue line for another 1 hour, then our target would be to close above this 38,860, closing above which and confirming it as a support would give us a target of $43,000. Now, this is the bullish scenario. What could be the bearish scenario? The bearish scenario could be we can very well come below this resistance that we were forming right from 12th of May, and we can come below it and treat this as a resistance again. Worst what can happen is we can drop right up to $35,900, which is basically the 61.8 level Fibonacci, which I feel will provide a great support for Bitcoin going forward. If we tend to fall below this, then probably we are looking at another testing of this lower part of the falling wedge. But that's the bearish scenario. So whether you should be buying Bitcoin or not, again, I will wait for us to close above at least another candle above this line of 37,200. And then I would be taking a trade with, of course, the target being 38,860 and a stop loss of about 36,600. Again, this is not a financial advice. I am not a financial advisor. You need to do your own research. But these are the levels that I will be putting my trades on. Now, let's jump onto another Bitcoin chart, and I want to show you something very interesting. So we are on the Bitcoin USD daily chart here, and one of the things that I want to highlight over here is basically we formed an Elliott impulse wave right from 25th of September. This is on the daily time frame. So what happens on the impulse wave basically is it's a 5-wave series wherein the first wave, third wave, and the fifth wave is generally the waves pointing up or moving north, and the wave 2 and wave 4 are waves pointing down. And there's one more rule, is that the third wave cannot be the shortest wave, and it's often the longest wave as well. Now, what happens after this impulse wave is we have a classic ABC correction. Now, what we can see over here is we formed the first wave right from September to about November. Then we had a correction in November. That was our second wave. Then the third wave started from November. It carried on right up to January. Then we had a fourth wave which corrected back again about time of 26 January or so. Then we had the fifth wave which took us right to about 21st of February. After the fifth wave, we have the ABC correction. So the ABC, the first wave is generally down. Wave B is the one which takes us to north again. And then we have another wave, which is the third wave, the C wave, which takes us down again. Now, what is important from here is basically after this completion, we will start another 5-wave impulse series. Now, if history is any indication, we can measure how much did we grow by in the last wave, okay? So we grew by almost 480% from our bottom to the top of the fifth wave. Now, if you have to grow by that, so let's assume that the third wave ended right here and the beginning of the 5-wave series starts from today. So 480% will take us approximately to about $200,000. Now, do I think this is possible? There are certain other criteria as well which we need to fulfill, but if those criteria gets fulfilled, I definitely think 200,000 is achievable in this market cycle. Now, I want to show you something very interesting about the Bitcoin dominance. So the Bitcoin dominance at this point of time is at about 45%. One of the important things that I would like to highlight here is irrespective of any asset or any chart that you are following, okay, the Fibonacci is a series which will help you deciding the support and the resistance on every kind of asset that you trade on, okay? For example, here, even in the dominance, we can see that we treated this 46.91 level as a strong resistance for us for 3 consecutive weeks, right? For the week starting 10th of May, then the week starting 17th of May and the week that started on the 24th of May. So what do I feel basically going forward? I feel when Bitcoin will start rising, we might treat this as a support and go as high as 52.64%. Now that is the most that I feel we would be going in this bull market cycle. Now after this, what I expect is we should be coming down to about 18% or so, which will mark the parabolic altcoin season. So you definitely need to be ready for that move. That's pretty much it about today's video. Do let me know how you feel about it by commenting below. Where do you feel Bitcoin dominance would be about a month from now? Also, if you like the content, please smash the like button and subscribe to our channel. This will help us in understanding that you are liking our content. Also, please share our content across your network. Let them understand what are the key levels of support and resistance for Bitcoin and where is it that they should be making their trades. And more importantly, stay safe, stay healthy, take very good care of yourself. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye for now.